This conference will now be recorded.
So we are discussing about Terraform. So in this we are creating a complete infrastructure we are going to create. So for example, we want to create one VPC. So previously I told about VPC, and we can create subnet, and we want to create some servers. So for example, I want to create two front end server I want to create. So this is in the public subnet, and also I want to create some database server in the back end subnet, and I want to create also a load balancer I want to create. So this all I want to create, but I need a gateway, internet gateway. So I need something called routing table. So there are so many things we are going to create. So this all we are going to create, it will take some 30 minutes. So we are going to create everything through the Terraform script. So I'm going to configure AWS CLI. So already AWS CLI is installed in my system. So I'm just checking it. CMD. So I can check AWS version command. It is seen that AWS CLI is installed, but I have to configure it. AWS configure command I have to give. So then I have to give the user IDs. So I need a user ID. I will quickly create as user. I will create. So I'm going to IAM, and I want to create a user. So I'm going to create some user. I want to create. I'm creating a user called user one, and I am giving programmatic access, and I want to give existing policy I am attaching. So I'm giving administrator access. I'm giving, so everything I'm giving, nest I'm giving, and I am creating a nest, and I'm creating a user. So user is created, and we will get the keys for this user, and I am can even download this credential. So I'm going to copy this access key and secret key. All I'm going to copy. So I'm going to copy this, and I am going to paste in my AWS command prompt. So I'm giving AWS configure command. So I'm going to paste the access key. So I'm giving AWS configure, and I'm giving access key. I'm giving, and then also I'm giving the secret key. So I'm giving AWS configure. So I'm going to copy this secret access key. So first I am copying access key, then I will copy the secret key. So I'm going to take the secret key of this user. And I am using maybe Mumbai region. I am using AP South one. I am using, so I can check my, it is working. Just checking my S3 bucket. Sorry. So I can check my command is working. AWS S3 means it will show all the S3 buckets are showing. It is just making me verifying this is installed. So now I am going to download Terraform, and I want to create a VPC. Everything I am going to create from the Terraform script. So I'm going to download Terraform download. So I'm going to download the Terraform program, and I'm going to copy this. So I'm going to download the 64-bit program I'm downloading. So I'm copying this program into C colon some Terraform folder. I'm pasting it. So now I need the template file for VPC. So the first file is AWS provider option I'm giving. So I want to create a provider option, and using this I want to any script, anytime we create a script, has to start with this one. So I have to take, suppose I can create VPC also, I can create the same time. So I'm giving the provider session. So I will go to this directory and I will going to this directory. So Terraform directory, I will create a script. I'm going to create the Terraform template file I'm going to create. So I'm pasted this script I am pasted. So that is a starting. So I can save it as a main.tf file. So I'm going to save it as a TF extension file. So now I want to create a VPC. I want to create. So I can search for the code for AWS VPC TF. So I want to create one Terraform VPC. I'm going to create. So VPC is the network we are creating. So I can take this code for creating a VPC. I'm going to paste in this script. So what is my VPC name? So my VPC name, I can give some name VPC one, and my tag also I'm giving VPC one. So I can create one by one. I am going to create. So now I will creating. Now I can start creating this VPC, and I want to create many things. I want to create. So I want to create a subnets. I want to create. So I want to create. Or out internet gateway, so many things I want to create. So I'm going to use command prompt. I will go to the project directory. So what is that? What script directory I'm going? So I'm giving a Terraform init. I'm giving, so it will initialize. So then I have to do Terraform plan and Terraform apply. I'm giving. So I want to create the servers. So, but we have before doing this, we have to know manually how to do all these steps. So Terraform plan. I'm going to create. So I'm going to create a I'm going to do Terraform apply command. So it is going to create a VPC. It is going to create. So what are the range and all we given here? This is the range we are giving. So in the range, they are going to create a VPC. So we can verify that one VPC is created. I'm going to AWS console. So I can check the VPCs are created. We can see one VPC one is created. So now I want to create a subnets. So maybe I want to create two subnets. I want to create. So I want to get a code for a subnet creation. So I want to create a Terraform code for subnet creation. So I will take this code now. So this is I'm going to create one subnet I want to create. So I will copy in this script. So I need to create two subnets. One is a maybe public subnet, other is a private subnet. Just a minimum I'm creating. So this is I'm giving as a public subnet. So I am creating as a public subnet. I am creating. This is the range I am creating. So if I give this script, it will not work because we are calling this VPC's ID. We are automatically taking. So we have to give. We are giving interpolation AWS underscore VPC, and this is the VPC name I have to change. So I have to change the VPC name, and then I will create this. Create this subnet. So same way I can create a private subnet also. I want to create this, so I can give it as private subnet, and I will give the range as 10.02. So this is the some logical name I am giving. So creating a private subnet I am creating. So two subnets I am creating. So this is the tag value and this is the logical name we are using. So when we are automatically getting the VPC ID we are getting. So now I want to create these two subnets I want to create. So I'm going to give Terraform up. So it is going to create two subnets. So we can see that two subnets also created. So we can go to AWS VPC and we can check the subnet. It is created, two subnets is created. Now I want to create a, what next is we need to create an internet gateway, because we want to connect from outside, we need an internet gateway. So that I have to create. So I'm going to create one internet gateway through Terraform script. So we will get a code for this. So this is the internet gateway we are creating. So I'm going to create an internet gateway. So, and also I have to specify the VPC ID also I have to specify. So I will giving a code for this. I'm creating internet gateway. I'm creating. So the internet gateway name is, I'm just going to give a name is IGW. Just for this one, anything I can change. So I'm giving IGW. And here a VPC value we are taking through automatically through interpolation. So I'm giving the value as VPC1. So now I'm going to create an internet gateway. I'm going to create. So I'm saving it and I'm giving Terraform apply command. I'm going to do. So I'm giving Terraform init, Terraform plan and Terraform apply and create. So I'm giving Terraform apply command. So now we can see that one gateway will create now. So we can see that internet gateway is going to be created. I can check internet gateway. There was only one IG internet gateway was there. So I will refresh it and I can check it now. So we can see that there is two internet gateways are there, IGW also created. So now I need to create two routing tables I have to create. So we need a routing table. So I need a creating a routing table. So I will get the code for Terra routing table. So I need to create two routing table, public routing table and private routing table. So I will create a routing table. So I'm going to paste here. So I'm creating a routing table I am going to create. So I'm giving a name like the public RT. And we have to take the VPC value ID value want to take it. So the VPC value is VPC1.id. And we are going to add a routing table. So we are telling all the outside external all the additional traffics we are going to send to routing. We are going to send this to internet gateway. So I'm adding a route value. So this one I am giving 000 pointing to internet gateway. So I'm going to give I'm going to redirect my all the traffic to internet gateway. 00 means any traffic we want to send outside, we have to go to this internet gateway. But internet gateway's name I have to change. because the logical name, whatever logical name we have given here, so the gateway ID we are automatically taking. So I created an internet gateway. That gateway value ID number they are automatically taking. So this one we are giving. So I am going to create a public routing table. I am creating. So same way, I want to create one private routing table also. I am creating one more routing table. I am creating. Same. Creating a routing table, it is giving us a private routing table. And I want to, but I am not giving this route entry now because actually it has to pass to a internet gateway. So I'm not adding that one here. So this I am just creating a routing table, but I am not adding a route entry. I am not adding. So I'm going to create two routing table. I am going to create. So I'm going to run this command now. For a minute, I can give. So there is an error it is showing. So whenever the bracket, I think we have to close this. I think that was the issue. So I'm going to try it again. So I given the Terraform minute. So I'm giving Terraform plan. I am giving. So Terraform apply also I am going to create. So now it is going to create a two routing table. It is going to create. So I'm giving yes. So we can see that two routing tables are created. So I can go here and check the routing table here. So there is not only one or two are there. So I will be seeing that two routing tables are created. One is a public and private routing table. So these are the new two routing tables are created. So I think I have not given the tag value. So otherwise I can understand that if I give the tag means I will easily understand it. So because I have not given the tag, if you want, you can give the tag like this. We can give, I can just give here again also. So I want to give a tag means I can add here. So the tag I can give us private public route table. So like that in both the routing table, I have to give that tag value I have to give. So now I can save it and I can update it. So this is the I'm going to give us private RT. So I can update it doing Terraform apply. So we can check it now. So before I was not able to identify this route. So I can give here, it is showing public routing table and private routing table. So I can go to public routing table and then I can check the routes here. So we can see edit route here. So we can see this route automatically added here. So I added, so 00 pointing to internet gateway. It is automatically added here. So private routing table, I not added entry. Now I have to see one more thing. Public routing table, I have some subnet association I have to do. It was not associated to any subnet. So we have to specify public routing table is for which subnet. So I can take a code for that. So I'm going to do public route table association. Route table association I am giving. So I will get a code for route table association. I want to take this. So this is a route table association I am getting. So one routing table I want to associate with a subnet. So this code I am going to give here. So I am going to give a subnet association. This can be anything, association one. Yeah. And what is this subnet value? Subnet value is I have given a value. What is the subnet value? So subnet value is I have given public private public subnet. So this is a public subnet. This value I have to paste here. So I have to copy this. And this is my subnet. I am going to associate. This is my subnet value I am giving here. And this is my route table value. So what is my routing table value? So routing table name is public RT. So I'm associating this subnet with the routing table. So the ID value I am giving here. So same step I am going to do here again. Private routing table, I want to associate with the private subnet. So I'm going to give this. So this association value I can give as B or something. And I want to change this public subnet so to private subnet. So my private subnet logical ID I want to take. So I have to take this private subnet I'm going to take. I'm going to copy this and I'm pasting this. So the subnet I'm changing. And this routing table also I'm changing. So what is the routing table name is private routing table. So the same value I have to give. So the logical value what whichever I given, so that I have to paste here. I have to paste. So I'm going to do a association public key and private subnet association I'm going to do, and I want to run this command. So all like that we are going to complete. So I'm going to do terraform init. So I'm giving terraform plan. So I'm going to do terraform apply. I want to create. So we created this. So now I want this, all the steps are completed now. So now everything we completed. So we can check here, verify here. We can go to routing table and public routing table. We can check this subnet association. If we verify, we can see that it has to be associated with one subnet because I given the association. So we can see this checkbox is came because it is associated with the public subnet. So the private routing table associated with the private subnet. So we can check the subnet association. And we can check edit here and we can check it is associating with the private subnet. So now I have already done everything. So now I need another gateway required. So if we need another gateway, we are going to create. So this called NAT gateway. So the NAT gateway will come in the public subnet. So I want to create a NAT gateway. I want to create. So because database servers and all, they want to connect to internet, we are communicating through NAT gateway. So I'm going to take the code for NAT gateway. NAT gateway I'm taking. So I'm going to take the code for Terraform. So I'm going to take the code for NAT gateway. So I am going to create a NAT gateway. I am going to create now. So I'm going to take the code for NAT gateway. So when we create a NAT gateway, we have to create in the public subnet. And also we need a Elastic IP also we required. Because whenever we creating a NAT gateway, it will also ask for creating a Elastic IP. So I am going to create a NAT gateway. So the NAT gateway name I am giving us, this is a logical name I am giving, NAT gateway. And what is my, I need Elastic IP. So subnet ID. So what is your subnet name you have to change here? So my subnet I will check. So public subnet. So that's the subnet value I am giving here. So automatically we want to get the subnet ID. So I am going to copy the subnet ID I am going to put here. So I am going to change the subnet value from here. So through interpolation, we are taking the subnet ID. And the Elastic IP I need. So what is the Elastic IP? So I don't have Elastic IP. So I have to create the Elastic IP. So I have to give AWS Elastic IP and Terraform. So I have to create a Elastic IP also. I have to create through Terraform. So I'm going to take the Elastic IP. So I am just creating a Elastic IP I'm creating. So I can create a Elastic IP before the NAT gateway. Will create a Elastic IP. So Elastic IP name I can give anything. So I can just give NAT or something. NAT EIP. So I'm giving a name like NAT EIP. And this is not connecting to a instance or something. So I'm not giving here. So I'm creating a Elastic IP. So that Elastic IP name I am giving here. NAT Elastic IP I'm giving. So this is the, I'm pointing to location ID means I am providing the Elastic IP, but this is my logical name of Elastic IP also I am giving. So it will create a elastic IP. Elastic IP will be assigning to the NAT gateway. So now I am saving and I want to run the code now. So I'm going to run the AWS. I'm going to give the init command. So NAT gateway is a managed gateway. It will take some time to create. So I'm going to give Terraform plan command I want to create. So I'm going to give Terraform apply command I'm giving. So I'm going to add the NAT gateway I'm going to add. So it will create a NAT gateway, but the next thing is I will add, the next step is I will add the private routing table, routing table of the private routing table also I have to add. So it is creating now, it is still creating. We can see that when we go to the NAT gateway, one NAT gateway is going to be created now. So it will be creating. So it is creating, it will take some time. So next is in the routing table of the private routing table. So in the routes, I have to add a value. I have to add an entry 00 pointing to NAT gateway. So that I have to add. So that step also I have to give. So after it is completed, I will do that. So it is still completing. So I have completed almost all the steps for creating. So I created only one subnet, public subnet and private subnet. Created a internet gateway. And I created a public routing table. And I'm also created a private routing table. So I have done all these things. So this is a VPC. Inside the VPC, I have two subnets. So these all steps I am doing. So it is still creating. It will take some time. So now I can start creating one server also. Web server I can create in the public subnet. And I have created, I want to create a DB server in the private subnet. So this all steps we are going to complete. So it will be just taking some time to create it. But not gateway, because it will be taking some time. So it is created now. So now next step is I want to edit the routing table or private routing table. I want to add entry. So I will go to the private routing table. So I have to add a entry like this, a root entry I have to add. So I have to add a root entry I'm going to add in the private routing table. So I'm adding this entry here. So I'm telling whatever outside traffic we have to forward it to NAT gateway. So this one I'm changing to NAT gateway. And what is the NAT gateway's name? So I am forwarding the traffic to NAT gateway. So what is the NAT gateway name? Is NAT GW. So I want to forward the traffic to NAT gateway. So I'm giving this name as NAT gateway. So that is a logical name I am giving. So whatever traffic in the private subnet according to NAT gateway. So I'm saving it. So I want to run this command, Terraform apply command I'm giving. So then a root entry will be added. So I'm going to yes now. So we can verify this. I am going to this private routing table and I can edit and check it. So I can refresh and check it. So there is only one route is there. So we can see that additional route will be created 00 pointing to NAT gateway. So I given like this. So now this all done. So now very one more last step is I'm going to subnet. So in the subnet, public subnet, I want to give a option and the action I have to give a option like modify auto assign IP settings. So we want to automatically assign IP address. So the settings I am going to give. So whenever we create any instance in the subnet, public subnet, you have to automatically assign a public IP address. So we have, we can see this options will come. So map public IP on launch. So we have to give an option like it's a boolean value we are giving. Map public IP on launch. So I have to copy this session. So this I am going to add in this public subnet. So I'm going to this public subnet. I will be adding a section in here, public subnet. I am adding an option here. So we want to automatically the settings I am giving. So I am going to do this Terraform apply command again. So I'm going to do yes. So now I can see that in the before I am checking this setting, modify auto assign setting, it is not checkbox is not given, but I am giving through the Terraform. So we can see this checkbox is already given. So now I done almost all the things. So now I need to create two servers. So AWS EC2 or Terraform. So I want to create two servers through Terraform. So I will take the code for creating the EC2 instance. So I'm going to take the code I am taking. So I'm going to paste here. So two instances I want to create. So one is the database server and other is the web server. So one server is in the public subnet. So this server I am giving as a web server, and this is the AMI ID I will be taking. So I will be going to EC2 service, and I will take the EC2 ID, AMI ID I want to take. So I will just creating a server, and I will take the ID. So I will be taking the ID automatically from here. So from here I can take the ID. So I can take the ID from here. So this is my I'm just creating a Linux Amazon Linux instance. I'm taking this AMI ID. So and I'm going to paste this ID here because it is pointing to a Linux server. So same way I want to create one more server, that is I am going to create a database server also I'm creating. So but I want to create it in the private subnet. So I will be creating a DB server. So I want to change this tag also, I will change as DB. So I want to create the key also, I can give. So now I will take the subnet. So I want to give the subnet value I have to give. So there is a option we can select the subnet. So which subnet we want to create. So we can give the subnet ID, and we can specify which subnet we want to create the server. So I'm going to copy this. So I'm going to give this option subnet ID here. So in the subnet ID I will be pointing to my subnet. So which subnet I want to create this. So I can specify the subnet. So which subnet we want to take. So the subnet ID we can through interpolation. So the subnet value I want to automatically take. So I'm giving this subnet ID like this I'm giving. So similarly I need I have to put it in the second server. I want to put it in the private subnet. So I have to change the subnet into private subnet. So this server I want to create in the private subnet. So if I want to give some keys and all, I can provide the keys. We can specify security group and all, we can specify, but I'm giving limited information to create the server. So I am going to save it now. So I want to run this command. Also I will give the keys, so key values. So if you want to give the keys, we can give the what which key we want to use. Key name I can give, key underscore name I can give. So if I want to provide the key means I can give the key value, key name here, a key underscore name I can give us. So I have some key I have. So
यहाँ ऑलरेडी हम सम की आई क्रिएटेड, सो द केस आई एम सेलेक्टिंग, सो आई एम सेलेक्टिंग हियर, सो आई एम डूइंग दिस. So now I want to execute this command. I want to execute. So I'm going to apply it now. So I'm going to create two servers. One server is in the public subnet, other server is in the private subnet. One DB instance and it's going to create a web server instance. It is in the public subnet, so it is created now. So we can so we can see that two instances are created. So we can just verify this. So we can see that EC2 instance, and we can check it. So we can check it in the EC2 instance. So we can see that two instances are created. So one server is in the public instance. So web server is in the, we can check it is coming in the public subnet. So also we can check the database server is in the private instance, private subnet. So today we created a subnet, private subnet. So to created a VPC to subnets, and also we created internet gateway, route tables, NAT gateway, and instances all we created.